Dear students, now we are going to discuss about social skills training. So, appropriate social behaviors are necessary for any person to be an acceptable member of the society. In case of persons with intellectual disability or mental retardation, intensive training is needed to cultivate appropriate social behaviors. Instead of keeping them away from the society, giving them chances to mix the society from the childhood itself will lead them towards gaining social competence. The training should be started very early in the life. The family, the relatives, neighbors, friends, and the society are responsible for the social skills training of the persons with intellectual disability or mental retardation. Now, again, for the social skill training, waiting for the needs to be fulfilled, like playing with peers, sharing objects, greeting others, obeying commands, saying please, thank you, sorry appropriately, helping parents in household tasks, asking permission. So these are some of the examples of the social skills training which we can easily impart, or we can try for imparting all these social skills to our children with intellectual disability or students with intellectual disability. Talking turn, participating appropriately at meal time, dressing in a way appropriate to the situation, visiting relatives and friends, participating in social functions, behaving appropriately with the opposite sex, returning borrowed materials, identify human service provider and community helpers. Also, these complies the examples of social skills training which we can provide from various platforms, and we can start it from our home itself, and parents also can indulge in all these types of activities for gaining or attaining the social skill training for students with intellectual disability. Now coming to the classroom management. So firstly, seating arrangement. Children with special needs are easily distracted, so their desks should be kept away from the windows, doors, and activity centers in the classroom. The desks may be set in rows rather than using circular seating around large tables if possible. Learners with autism need their own space. The students with ADHD, that is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, is easily distracted. So a seat close to the teacher facing forward works best. Coming to the instructions, should be simple. Verbal prompts to be given frequently, and instructions should be easy to understand. Repetition of instructions will be required if the student does not seem to comprehend what is being said. Using of visual aids such as charts, graphs, and pictures are very essential, and it provides a very good platform for managing the classroom settings. Peers as role models, pairing compatible children together when working on projects or participating in classroom activities. This can give many children the opportunity to be a peer role model to the special needs student, and can also be predictable schedule. Advance warning is required if the daily schedule is to be changed. Teaching social skills such as hand raising, taking turns, and sharing as part of learning curriculum. All learners will benefit when reminders are given. Children with autism often engage in self-stimulating behaviors such as hand flapping, rocking, or even slapping themselves in the face. Intervening activities. Most children with intellectual disability have short attention span. So one has to be aware of the signs that they may need a short break. During the break activities, like reading a story, playing a short game, stand up, and stretching or casual conversations can be done. Sometimes an opportunity to get out of his seat and walk around the room can be very calming for the child with short attention span. Focusing on learner strengths. Learner strengths are to be appreciated openly, as such stance will boost learners to act further. Environmental distractors, loud noises, bright lights, and hot or cold temperatures can disrupt a child's thinking pattern and cause an unnecessary classroom outburst. These need to be eliminated whenever possible. And using computer-based programs also, we can manage in our classroom settings by providing many simple tasks. So they will be motivated also, and they will find easy to understand some of these steps also. Now, coming to the use of assistive technology. Assistive technology is the term used to describe devices used by people with intellectual disabilities and or other disabilities that help compensate for functional limitations and increase learning, independence, mobility, communication, environmental control, and choice. Different assistive technology devices are used to support specific needs of the learners. Assistive technology can help people with intellectual disabilities overcome barriers towards independence and inclusion. Technology can compensate for a person's functional limitations. People with intellectual disabilities should be introduced to assistive technology as early as possible. That's all in this video. Thank you very much.